people always wonder, when they find out that I'm vegan, where do you get your source of protein, because I'm not eating meat, dairy products and eggs? And I thought it was kind of obvious, but it's clearly over there. Right? It's over there. Actually, no, it's not. It's up there. It's up there, Karima, where is it? Up there. Yeah, it's up there. It's just up. Up there. Up there, right? Up here?
Yeah, this song is also coming from the Psalms of King David, the Tehillim, you know. You know, at that time, we could have a real understanding of a king, you know. For us, we don't know so much what's a kingdom or a king. You know, we live in a world of fragmentation where the majority of the people don't appreciate or care about so much the person that's running things, you know. At that time, the king was the people. The king was the people, meaning that all the people were a part of the king. The king loved the people with his whole heart. He would do anything for them. He was not just a politician, but he was a warrior, you know, a general on the front lines. He would die for his people. He was a singer, a writer, a poet, all these different things, you know, a real person. Oni oni vievyo Hashem yashavli Hezmasi humafati Oton. Said if you have been a refuge for me, a tower of strength in the face of the enemy, 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 oh, yo. From the end of the earth unto you I call, time and again I fall, back to you I call. You have been a refuge for me, a tower of strength in the face of the enemy, 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 enemy. Too many times, too many times, yeah. I give you my heart, I'm taking back what's mine. Yeah, you saved my soul from the other side, yeah. Oh, from the end of the earth unto you I call. Time and again I fall, back to you I crawl. See, you have been a refuge for me, a time of strength in the face of the enemy, enemy, enemy.
Again? Okay. You ready?
Yeah.
How many times? One, two, three. Three, four, five. Three. Okay. One, 1, 2, 3.
Now we're looking for a rare animal that goes by the name of Sepov Bai. It lurks here, and it does not consume any other animals, only vegetables.
Yo, what's up guys? I hope you enjoyed the video. I'm just going to explain a little bit of what I did that helped me get better from my ankle injury so fast. I was doing contrast bathing, which is where you put your foot into a bucket of ice for 1 minute and then you put it in a bucket of hot water for 1 minute and you do that 7 times. So that's really important. I was doing that 3 times a day for the first 2 weeks. And that really brought down the swelling. It gets the blood back into the injury, but also takes out the old blood, so it's like just circulating your injury a lot better than it would do otherwise. And I was keeping it completely natural. I didn't take any anti-inflammatory drugs. I had a lot of natural things such as arnica, which I used to rub onto my injury, which is really good. And I used to juice garlic and ginger, both for natural anti-inflammatories, and that seemed to help quite a lot as well. And I juice every day. I do that anyway regardless. Yeah, I do feel like the more fresh fruit and vegetables you have in your diet, the quicker everything recovers. You know, you're just a bit fresher, you've got more nutrients and vitamins and passing through your body quite quickly. So make sure you check those out. Another thing I would say is, like, whenever you've got illnesses or injuries or anything like that, like, it's always good to be eating like alkaline foods, not acidic foods. So acidic foods would be very high sugar foods, so I don't know, chocolate bars, sweets, fizzy drinks, stuff like that. And then alkaline foods are stuff like green vegetables and, well, vegetables in general are usually alkaline, and our bodies are alkaline, so if we can like help our bodies get into that alkaline state, it will give it more energy to do what it does better, which is recover. So if you are looking to recover from any illness or injury, I would always recommend like trying to put alkaline foods in your diet. That's why I always drink these green juices, because they're very famous for being strong alkaline drinks that help your body recover. Keeping well hydrated, drinking loads of water every day. I always have fresh water. I don't really drink tap water. I usually just get spring water, and it's only like 47p for like 2 liters, and I usually drink that before bed. Making sure that you get like 8 hours rest each night, sleeping well, not eating 2 hours before you go to bed, so that you can really sleep and not have to digest while you're sleeping. And also, you know, a positive mental attitude as well, like not worrying about your injury or your illness or anything like that, like, you know, accepting what happened to you and then finding out what can you do with it. So for instance, like my ankle injury, I couldn't do any more flips, I couldn't really dance, but it did give me an opportunity to work on my handstands, gave me an opportunity to work on my music, gave me an opportunity to
you know, spend time with my loved ones, my family, my friends. So I enjoyed my time. I wasn't unhappy while I was unwell. And I think, you know, that can help quite a lot if you are having a positive mind frame and you're enjoying the process. And who knows, maybe you'll learn something new, you'll discover something. I know I certainly did. So I don't regret what happened to me. And I think that's always good, just in life anyway. But, you know, I think a positive attitude can go a long way, even to do with your recovery time. I think that's it. I hope this has been helpful for you. And if you have any questions, just hit me up on Twitter, Kieran60, or write a comment on the YouTube or anything like that. And yeah, I'd be interested if this stuff has helped you or you've learned something, or if you want to share some of your experiences as well. All right, take care.